Have you been noticing some floaters or spots in your vision and wonder if it's anything serious that requires immediate medical attention? In today's video, I will describe the three most common causes of floaters as seen in my 10 years of practice as an optometrist. Hi, I'm Dr. Jennifer Wan, the optometrist of Ardent Vision Eyecare in Richmond Hill, Ontario. The first most common cause of floaters as seen in my practice is floaters due to aging. Let's first talk about where all floaters take place. There's a jelly-like structure that fills the eye that's called the vitreous. As part of normal aging, scattered bits of collagen fibers floating in the vitreous tend to clump together. When it causes a large enough lump to cast a shadow on the back of the eyes as light passes through the eyes, we perceive floaters. These floaters are noticed by people as young as in their teens and 20s, but it is more frequently noticed as one ages. The following are common characteristics of benign floaters due to aging. It usually involves a slow and gradual accumulation of a few transparent or gray floaters in the vision over time. They may not be always seen, but are most noticeable when one looks against a white wall, a white computer screen, or the sky. They may be seen in one or both eyes. The second most common cause of floaters, as seen in my practice, are floaters due to something called posterior vitreous detachment. A posterior vitreous detachment, or PVD in short, is a condition that is more common to those who are 50 years old or older, and by age 70, most people would have had it happen to at least one eye. Another type of change happens in the vitreous as one ages. Naturally, we are born with the vitreous attached to the back of the eyes. With time, the vitreous becomes less jelly-like and more liquid-like, and this causes it to pull away from the back of the eyes. As this happens, it usually tugs with it something called the Weiss ring, which is a pigmented or darker colored ring of tissue that originally acts as glue to glue the vitreous to the optic nerve at the back of the eyes. When the Weiss ring gets pulled into our line of vision, one might notice the following symptoms. Those with PVD may notice a sudden onset of one larger, more darkly pigmented floater, that is, the Weiss ring. If the ring is intact, some may describe seeing a donut-shaped floater. If the ring is broken, some may describe seeing a line or snake-like floater. Though it may not happen to everyone, the reason why some do experience flashes with a PVD is because as the vitreous tugs away from the back of the eye, it can also tug at the retina. The retina is a sensory blanket of neurons that detects light and helps us see. Just like a pinch on our skin can fire pain receptors to cause us to feel pain, a tug or stimulation on the light receptor cells on our retina can cause us to sense flashes of light. While flashes resulting from PVD are usually transient and can stop altogether over 4 to 12 weeks, it is recommended that anyone with PVD symptoms should have their eyes checked out by the optometrist just in case. This is because for a small number of people with a PVD, the vitreous can tug hard enough at the retina to cause a retinal tear or detachment. This leads us to the third most common cause of floaters as seen in my practice, and that is floaters due to a retinal tear or detachment. A retinal tear or detachment can be triggered by a PVD, a trauma or injury to the eye, as a complication after an eye surgery, and sometimes it just happens spontaneously. Those who have high nearsightedness and diabetes are also known to be at higher risk of having a retinal tear or detachment. As previously mentioned, the retina helps receive images and send signals to the brain to help us see. When a tear happens in the retina, countless dark granules from its structure are released into the vitreous. Floaters resulting from a retinal tear usually have the following characteristics. It usually involves a significant increase in many darker pigmented floaters in the affected eye, almost like seeing stars in the sky, but all black. These floaters are usually more apparent and not just noticeable against a plain background. And once they appear, they don't disappear. A retinal tear is often associated with seeing flashes, and one may even see a curtain in the vision of the affected eye. We discussed why flashes would be seen. Basically, any tension, including the peeling off of the retina, can cause them. Now, the reason why a curtain in the vision can be seen in a full-on retinal detachment is because fluid can pass through a retinal tear and lift off the rest of the retina. In the area where the retina is detached, it will no longer function to transmit light signals to help us see. As a result, a black curtain or a void in your vision would be noted. If you see these symptoms, seek immediate medical attention because the longer a retinal detachment goes untreated, the higher the risk of permanent vision loss in the affected eye. Those are the three most common causes of floaters I see in practice. My biggest advice would be any sudden onset of floaters should be checked out by your optometrist because, as we've discussed, while some floaters are benign, others are the first signs of a sight-threatening condition. If you live in the Greater Toronto Area and would like to consult me for your vision and eye health, you can contact me with the information provided in the description box below. If you learned something from today's video, please press the like button to show your support. Consider subscribing for more free eye health videos and hit that notification bell so you won't miss the next one. Thanks for watching. Bye.